part of the Student Conservation Association, serving as an estuary educator with the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation's Hudson River Estuary Program. For this video, I've brought you to John Boyd Thacher State Park in Albany County, New York, where we're going to talk a little bit about the geology of the Upper Hudson River Valley. Specifically, these really cool limestone formations and caves that we have in this area. Now, limestone is a special rock that forms from the shelly remains of ocean-dwelling creatures. And these limestones were deposited over 400 million years ago, which is 200 million years before dinosaurs would even walk the earth. So there's a lot of history here in these rocks. One of the reasons why these limestones here are so exciting is because they contain amazing fossils. They contain things like brachiopods, crinoid or sea lily stems, corals, and trilobites. As you look at the cliff behind me, you can see that there are these layers. You can almost think of these layers as being the bottom of the ocean floor at different points in time. So 400 million years ago, New York was located 30 degrees south of the equator, and it was covered in a warm tropical ocean. And so as you go from the bottom of this cliff to the top, we're actually looking up through time. In geology, there's this concept called the law of superposition, which basically states that unless rocks are twisted or compressed or overturned, older rock units will always be below younger rock units. The fossils that lived during this time, the older ones that existed, 430 million years ago, they died and were buried on the ocean floor on these layers down here. Then as you move up through time, younger and younger organisms can be found. And so it's just really great to be able to come to a place like this in our very own state. There's just so much history here to explore in the world around us. Another reason why limestone is so cool is because it reacts in interesting ways with water. So when water is polluted, or it filters through things like soil or leaf litter or detritus, it can become slightly acidic. Now, limestone, being a calcium carbonate, reacts with weak acid, and so it actually dissolves as the water filters through the bedrock. So over time, as water goes through these cracks and crevices that already exist in the limestone, they widen to form these beautiful, elaborate cave systems that exist in the Upper Hudson River estuary, as well as parts of central New York and even lower down in the Hudson River Valley. And caves themselves are also really interesting because they have a really regular humidity and temperature all year long. So caves in this part of the world, they stay about 40 degrees, even in the winter. So that means that right now I'm feeling this sort of like cool breeze behind me from this cave that you can see that extends pretty far back actually. And in the winter, if I was here, it would actually feel kind of cozy and warm if I sat here because it would still be 40 degrees. And so all of these organisms that have really sensitive environmental needs can thrive in places like caves, which makes them really, really ecologically valuable places. And so all of this water that is filtering through the bedrock here at John Boyd Thacher State Park will eventually make its way to the Hudson River estuary. So even places as far away from the Hudson River as this eventually make their way into the Hudson River system. So it's all connected. And it's just really cool to see how geology and ecology and hydrology all interact with each other to form a living system.